Hi, I'm Rich.
WB5YBZ.
And have you ever wondered how well is your antenna doing, or where is it really oriented? You have seen charts and things like this. Now, if you run on a beam, you have a pretty good idea where it's oriented, depending on where you are aiming it. So I'm using a 7300 and I'm using a WSPR program. So let's go on over to the computer, and thanks so much for watching.
You know, one of the things about using WSPR, I'm using 1 watt, and you wonder, well, I wonder how many people are hearing me and what can I hear on my antenna? Well, I just put up an 80 meter full wave loop, and I thought, well, I think I'll just see how it does over a while on 20 meters. And if you're familiar with WSPR, you can always see who's hearing you and who are you hearing. Well, I'm just running a 1 watt, and people in Italy and all over the place were hearing me. This is like 9 o'clock. Oh, I think it was October the 12th, about 9 or 10 o'clock in the morning. And you just can click on these names or call signs and tell you who's hearing you. And sometimes not only that, but stations I'm hearing. It's sort of a thrill that even with 1 watt, there was a guy in Antarctica that could hear my signal. If you're just starting out, you can maybe go for 10 minutes and see who's hearing you. And this is pretty neat too. But if you look at the north and south, you can see that my antenna orientation, even though I've talked to Kansas and stuff, isn't as strong as it is east and west. What I did is I went to the WSJTX page. I'll put this in the description. You go to this area here, WSJT-X. You can get the documentation, and you can go on down here. And I just, depending on what you're running, I'm running Windows 10, and both of these are version 2.20, and one of them's a 32-bit, and knowing your computer, whether it's 32 or 64, does make a difference. Mine's 64, and you just click it, and down at the bottom, it'll say whatever. And it says, do you really want to allow this app? And you go on and on and on and you agree and blah, blah, blah. And once you do that, we want to make sure that we have to set the settings. And what I do is put my call sign in, my grid square. You can look up QRZ.com. The only thing I have checked here is transmit message to RX frequency Windows. Radio is Icom 7300, COM port 4. And how do you got this COM port 4? Hopefully, if you go to device managers, device manager, hopefully you have gotten your Icom virtual port. See where it says Silicon Labs? Mine's COM port 4. Depending on your computer, you might have a bunch of COM ports. It might be 7, it might be 10, it might be 11, it might be 2, it might be 1. But look for the Silicon Labs, and you get your COM port or your virtual port from the Icom website. So COM port 4, the baud rate's 1900. That's what I have on my 7300, and I'll show you where it is. We have two different baud rates on the 7300, but this is for the serial port parameters. These three are default. This is for the cat, none, fake it. If you want to test it, well, make sure you have your audio, your microphone for your codec, and your output, your speakers for the codec. And back to the here, you can test it by clicking this. It should turn green. And testing the push to talk button. All right. Another thing, once you're are handshaking or connecting to your computer to your ham radio, all you have to do is switch, and it automatically switch to another band and the frequency where whisper is. I have it on 20. Another thing is you want to have it enabled, and you want to have, I'm using only 1 watt. It tells you how many watts that you're using. Very, very small amount, up to 1 watt. So I'm using 1 watt. Make sure you're enable on your transmitter. And let's go on over to the 7300.
Okay, let's go to hit the menu here. And we'll go to set, which is here. We go to connections. Let's just go through them all. Okay, the first one is AF. Your output level should be about 50%. The next one's off. It says open in brackets. And the next one says off. Now we're gonna move the screen down, one click. Most all those first two are on 50%. The next one is on 40%, and the next one is mic, I guess it's accessories, I don't remember what the ACC is. Data mode is USB, and I believe that is about it. Let's go on down. It says USB serial functions CI5. I don't know what this USB sending keying is. I have RST, DTR, DTR, on. Let's go down one more page. I guess that's it. So we're going to go back, connections, CI5, I think it is. Let's go all the way up to the top of the screen. Now, this is a different baud rate. See, it says CIV baud rate. I have it just on auto. The CI, I call it V, I think it's 5. CI5 address is 94H. That's the 7300 address. CIV transceives on, or CI5 USB is 001. And we're going to go page down. And, okay, the next one's, the first one's off, and I have it unlinked from remote for the next one. And remember I was telling you about the baud rate on the software? Well, there it is. It's 19200, same thing as I have it on the software. Now, you could probably increase it if you wanted to, or decrease it, but you have to have it the same as the software. The next one, the echo back's down. We're going to go down one page. I guess that's it. So that's about it as far as the 7300. Oh, one more thing. Let me get out of here. You want to run at low power. Notice I have 1% up here. That means 1 watt out. Also, I have my Vox on over here. And that's just pushing the Vox on or off button, but I have my Vox on. Another thing is I have my USB and I have my data pushed for upper sideband.
Once you're in WhisperNet map, it might not show a map immediately, but like I say, Microsoft Edge seems like it works great for me. So what I do is I put, what band was I transmitting and receiving on? And they have so many different bands, but I use 20 meters. I put my call sign in here. I don't even worry about this longitude, latitude stuff. And I want it for whatever time period, 10 minutes, 30 minutes, and 1 hour, or 12 hours, 24 hours. If you have it a long time, you might want to see how it does. All right, let's see here. I have it for 10. I'm going to put it for 10 minutes. I'm going to hit update right here. And I hit OK. And again, you can enlarge this. Now, as the propagation, the sun's going down, it's less signals. It's 7:30, the sun's down almost, 7:15 at night. And you see the propagation's more going to the west now. Now, when I first started was maybe 40 minutes ago, but let's go for the last hour. Now let's hit update and just see how things had changed. And as you can see, things had changed because you can see that at an hour ago, 45 minutes ago, I was receiving a lot of East Coast, or they were receiving me, hearing WB5YBZ and heard by WB5YBZ. All right, now let's go back to 10 minutes and just see who's hearing me and what I'm hearing. I'm going to hit 10 minutes. I'm going to hit update. And sometimes it takes a little bit. And virtually the East Coast is completely gone almost. Let's see, are they hearing me or am I hearing this? They're hearing me in Florida, hearing me, and down here they're hearing me. And this is heard by, in other words, they're hearing I'm hearing that signal. And also this one. Let's see what this one says hearing. And I think they said they were hearing me there. All right, if you look at the blue arrow, this is north. So my antenna is going a little bit more, I guess you might say this area would be a little bit north, northeast. This is similar to this is where the balun is mounted at the top of the pole in a birdhouse. If you're interested in my antenna, you can look at my 80 meter full wave loop, and it goes to another birdhouse that's 25 feet off. This is about 25 feet off. Then it goes up to about 40 feet up here. But the way it's radiating, it looks like it's radiating from a vertical line from the north. And with the balun being here, I don't know. It just sort of blows my mind. If you remember, it goes more like to the northeast and comes around all the way to about the southeast and comes back. And then goes up to the northwest, to the southwest, and comes back around. I'm not sure why. I thought it would probably be more directional this way, you might say, because the balance here, I thought it'd be shooting off this way to the south, southeast, but it's not. It's just sort of surprising. But this is how my antenna's laid out. All in all, using the Icom 7300 with a minimum of 1 watt, only 1 watt, you can see the radiation pattern of your antenna and know approximately where your strong points are and also where your weak points are with using WSPR. Thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate you watching my videos.